that one in the chest, heavy blood loss, blood pressure drop. Make sure we have uncrossed max blood rating, 5 milligrams of morphine, IV. So
this is simple, Maggie. All you have to do is tell the truth. It's the easiest thing to remember. When you first got there.
If you brought us gifts, that's different.
Okay, well.
Anyone else at that time?
Luke.
Hey, baby, how's it going?
Good.
Long time.
I know, long time no see. How are you?
I'm great. Let me get these.
Oh, no.
Okay. You need help, just yell.
Okay.
And while you're at it, maybe get Hannah up dancing or something, because her ass is just too fine to be sitting
Stephanie,
in that chair all day.
Stephanie, I'm going to slap your husband for being inappropriate.
Ladies, have your gifts.
Beautiful.
Yes, Maggie's here, and she's joining us for dinner.
Good.
Jean, where'd you keep the vases in here?
I don't know. I can't find anything. So in your search, if you find a calendar, give me a call. You know, in fact, you should give me a call to let me know why my daughter doesn't call. Because
this has nothing to do with him.
Wait. What has nothing to do with me? What has nothing to do with me?
You don't communicate. That's what the problem is.
Well,
does this look like it's a problem?
I don't see any grandbabies. So, obviously, there's some problem with intercourse somewhere.
We just got married. Ooh. Stop it. I'm not talking about sex with my mother-in-law again.
Oh, well, no. You may not want to talk about it, but let me tell you, what were you doing during that 6-year engagement?
I am not having sex with my mother-in-law.
Out.
No.
Get out.
Give me a glass of wine.
No.
You've had too many.
The house looks wonderful. You should banish me.
That's funny, Jean. I was thinking the exact same thing.
We didn't banish anyone. We just didn't want you around. Well, if you wanted to be alone, you should have gone on a vacation to a beach with rum drinks and a little umbrella.
Jean, have a glass of wine. I think you'll find that's called a staycation.
It's environmentally friendly.
It's basically a vacation, but at home.
For a whole year. It wasn't a year, Mom. It felt like a year. And besides, a staycation, it sounds like something poor people do.
Mom.
Jean, it's awful. You're an awful snob. You are.
I know that you're not poor, although I don't exactly know how you make money with an online clothing store, because people can just order things and then they can wear them out to a, you know, a rave or whatever. And then, don't laugh at me. And then they can just send it back and expect a full
refund. That is something that you and Jean want.
Sorry, hang on a minute. Jean, are you telling me you go to raves? Because I have to see
it. Frequently.
Killer moves. Very, very sexy.
Yeah.
No, most people are cool, you know. I suppose we do get stuff back that smells kind of like fish food. But we have a special file for those guys, don't we?
Yes, we do. Fish food file.
Very clever.
Is that a compliment?
Mm-hmm. You just stop while you're ahead.
I think it was. This looks delicious. Let's start. Thank you to the chef.
Thank you, chef.
Cheers.
Cheers. Cheers.
Great.
No, thank you.
Ever since you found out Cabernet has calories, you're scared of it.
No.
I'm terrified.
Hannah, sweetie, that's your third glass. I know that, Mom. My husband's an accountant.
Yes, I'm just saying that you have to be careful about mixing alcohol in your med.
It makes your teeth so pretty and pink.
I'm fine, Mom.
No, you're not.
Mom, can you pass Maggie the sauce?
No one gives a shit about the sauce.
You are an Olympic deflector. Why are we not really talking here?
Honesty is healthy.
You guys are so desperate to be cheerful, and we're acting like nothing happened. This is what happens when families are apart too long.
Jean, you know, I think the important thing right now is that we are all here.
Only because we were allowed to be here.
Yeah, and it means a lot. And okay.
I think that Emma would have really liked it.
Yeah, it feels good to be together again, as a family.
Yes, it does.
Michael and Hannah, I love you both so much, and I think that the best thing you have to offer the world is your combined gene pool. And I think the family should expand, and I want some grandbabies to squeeze.
If you don't need a therapist, why do you need those?
Therapy is doing nothing but making me more depressed, Mom.
Then change therapists.
You think that you could just come in here and start telling me what to do?
Do you know what it's like to lose a child, Dr. Woods?
No.
Well, it's like she's not where she's supposed to be. She's not in my arms. And I know she's gone, but that doesn't stop me from looking for her.
So then Bethany came back and bought this Feng Shui CD. It sounded so bad, it sounded like Japanese porn music. So I played it the next time we've done it.
TMI for
another
one.
Sorry.
Weird, I keep thinking she's still up in her room and we're going to wake her up.
Hey.
I'm so sorry.
It's okay. No. We're fine, really. We're just glad you're here.
Maggie, can you hurry up with that sugar rush before my husband bores us to death with one of his speeches?
Yeah, well, it looks terrific. Let's cut in.
1 second, Jean.
Too late.
Thank you for the introduction, sweetheart. We just wanted to say it's been a difficult year, but in honor of her birthday. To Emma.
To Emma.
Now let's have some cake.
So weird, the knife just went by itself.
Whoa, that was weird.
No, silly, you just bumped the table.
What's in this coffee?
Here you go.
Okay, as I remember, big pieces for the boys, yes?
Excuse me.
Babe? Honey?
Now, why don't you tell me how the others died?
You look terrible. Are you pregnant?
No. Can we just not have this conversation?
What are you waiting for?
Well, now, it's just not fair to Hannah, you know?
What's not fair to Hannah? I should have come before.
But you couldn't.
Well, now I am.
See? I don't want to come here and make you feel bad, you know. I got a little emotional.
I've been such a mess that it doesn't even matter.
Okay?
Wait.
I'm sorry.
You didn't invite me to come to be with you. And yet, you asked her. Is that right? And did you come?
No.
I bet you didn't even get an email saying that she was too busy. Totally understandable.
Mom, I invited Bethany to come because she doesn't judge me, and Luke because he makes Michael laugh.
But you didn't come because of your precious emotions. You've always been a narcissist.
Mom, that's not... She's right. No, she's not. I'm sorry. It gave me a chance, or just gave me a reason not to clear out her room. I thought maybe you'd want to say goodbye.
I'd like that.
I know. I do it every day.
Always had a flair for the dramatic.
She just needs a minute. Cocktails, anyone?
Mm-hmm.
You know, I think I'll make some tea. Would anyone else like some tea?
No thanks, Mom.
Hannah, should I go check on Bethany? She's fine, but I imagine being the world's first human magnet wouldn't mess with your head a little.
I'm sorry, did that not just freak everyone the fuck out?
You know, there has to be a legislation to that.
Well, the lodestone is indigenous to this area. You take the ocean being nearby, full moon in the springtide, and probably cause some kind of freak electromagnetic reaction.
Really? And I just saw an Asian leprechaun with an afro one by the front door. You've got too much time in your...
What? Did you guys just hear that?
What?
Did you hear something?
I didn't hear anything.
I thought I heard a screaming.
I'm going to go check on Bethany. I'll be back in a minute.
You didn't hear that?
No, I didn't.
You didn't just hear that?
I'm sure it was Jean.
Just passed out.
Do you want me to call you a doctor?
No. I'm just exhausted. I don't want to cause any more fuss. Okay. Am I interrupting anything?
Hey. No, not at all. Maybe you can come in here and talk some sense to your sister. I think she might need a little doctor.
I don't need to see a doctor.
I'll leave you guys alone. See you later.
mother.
Cast me out into the ungodly and turn me over into the hands of the wicked.
What are you saying?
You're under the wicked.
Bethany, are you okay? Bethany, stop that owl. You're scaring me. Stop.
Your secret.
Stop it, Bethany. It's not fucking funny anymore. Let go of me. Stop it.
Sister was in a recovery center in 1996 for exhaustion. Interesting euphemism. What was she in recovery for?
She was in rehab for like a week. But it was because she was having panic attacks. I guess she thought the pot smoking might help.
These panic attacks, were they a result of her drug use, or was the psychosis a pre-existing condition?
No, she wasn't a drug addict, and she wasn't mentally ill. She was just ranting like she was batshit crazy.
Sweetheart, please, you know how she is. Don't let her rattle your cage so much.
Yeah. My family drives me nuts.
I know.
Everybody's does, right?
Bethany, calm her down.
Hannah, you'll get the pills now. What pills? What?
Please.
We don't know what she already ate. Okay. She could have been high already. Bethany?
Try this again, shall we? Did you write the message, Luke?
If you think I'd write some fucked up message to my in-laws about their dead daughter, then maybe you're the one who needs her head checked.
Sweetheart, garbage disposals don't just turn themselves on.
I'm not crazy, Michael. I tried to turn it off. I did. It wouldn't turn off.
Guys, do you think this could be Emma? Like, Emma's spirit, maybe?
No. Her ghost, maybe.
Please, let's not go there.
Her ghost?
Why wouldn't she have just gone straight to heaven? I mean, Emma was only 3 years old, for Christ's sake.
I know someone that can help us. I can get her to come over.
Is she a doctor?
She's someone that can tell us if it's really Emma or not. Worst case scenario, we rule out any other sort of possibilities. So, you mean she's a psychic?
The last thing we need is some woo-woo, carny, weirdo that... What kind of person comes to strangers' houses in the middle of the night?
Michael?
Jean, if she's here, I want to know.
Bethany wrote it.
Bethany wrote it, Jean? Really? How? And how did she do that? If my wife is crazy, I want to know.
Hey, I want to go to bed.
Keep an eye on her tonight. Get her a doctor first thing in the morning. But I know she should rest. Maggie. Call your friend.
Do you think your wife was possessed?
No. I don't know. I don't know anything. I don't even know how we ended up with a psychic.
Samara, come in. Can I take your jacket or... Do you mind if we skip the pleasantries and I just take a look around?
Yeah, do you mind if I come with?
Yeah, I do, actually. Emma's room is upstairs to the left.
Yeah, it is.
That wasn't a question. Where are the others?
In the dining room.
Keep them there. Get it. Well, congratulations. There is definitely a presence here. That's a pretty strong one. How old was Emma when she died?
She was
almost four.
And how long have you been
Shouldn't
in this house?
Shouldn't you know all this already?
Almost 5 years.
How did she die?
It was an accident at home.
I found her.
Okay. I'm going to need some candles, white ones preferably. I'm going to try to make contact with this entity. Okay, so before we begin, I must warn you that this is serious shit. This is not a game. And if anybody needs to go to the bathroom, I suggest that you do so now. Because people have been known to piss their pants.
I'll be right by.
That was Emma's. Please concentrate. Focus. Guiding spirits to quote each and every soul in this room tonight in your glowing white light. I'd also like to invite the four archangels to be the gatekeepers, Michael to be the protector, Uriel to guard the circle, Gabriel to be the communicator, and Raphael to be the healer. I ask that the masters keep this room bathed in white light, and may we always be acting for the highest good. Thank you. Amen.
Amen.
Abracadabra.
Maggie, could you please change seats with Luke?
Any reason?
You're pretty. We are here tonight to try to make contact with Emma Anderson, the young girl who died in this house. Emma, are you here with us? Emma, would you like to speak to us? Emma, is that you? Are you the young girl Emma that died in this house? Where are you, Emma? How did you get in Bethany's house? Mommy took you to Bethany's house?
What did she mean by Bethany's house?
Are you mad at Mommy, Emma?
Okay, this is bullshit.
Sit back down.
I'm done with this, okay? Enough!
Please.
Are you kidding me?
Is it because Mommy didn't come with you?
Are you gonna just sit here and listen to this woman?
Because Mommy couldn't come to where you are? Did it hurt you when you died, Emma?
Get this woman out of my house right now!
I'll get the lights.
Once invited into play, darkness does not go away.
Oh,
there is no God here, lover. Not that that would bother you, Hannah. How one lives with herself, I really like.
Please, you know. Who are you?
Please. What do you want, Miss Beth?
Oh, nothing that 53 men haven't done before you, Luke. Bethany is me. I am Bethany. We're the best.
You stay away from my wife.
Or what? Exactly, you spineless worm.
So, what happened after the table shook and Samara teleported from one side of the room to the other?
Afterwards. Don't you think our minds sometimes block things out for a reason?
That's okay. You don't have to talk to me, Michael. You don't have to tell me things. I've been doing this for damn near 22 years. It's an unfair advantage. Most killers don't have that much experience.
You got it. She's looking better. You okay, princess?
She does.
Ask Michael.
Tell me she's wrong, Michael. Is she wrong, Michael?
Come on, Michael. No secrets anymore. You both know you still think about sleeping with
Tell
me
she's wrong. No! Stop it! Ow!
Sorry.
Stop!
Oh.
Bastard!
Oh, Hannah. You know you married a whore. And by the way, the sluttier you act, the more pathetic you look, and the more you disgust.
Stop it now, okay? Stop it, Bethany! Stop it!
Hannah, I love you. There's only you.
Liar!
He's always wanted me more. Look at you. Don't think she doesn't lie to you too, Michael. Tell me a secret, Hannah.
What?
Tell me. Hannah didn't just fall down the stairs all on her own, did she now?
Hannah. I'm asking you, what did you do to Emma?
Emma's favorite thing about working from home was the fact that she didn't have to drive. She could drink as much as she wanted.
Anna didn't find Emma at the bottom of the stairs.
No.
She put her there.
You lie! Shut up, Jeff!
Toddler in one arm, drink in the other. She lost her stuff. She dropped her child. But not the drink, no. She didn't spill a drop.
Oh, God, no!
How do you know this?
Who are you?
Google Isle. Where the flies. I can see into your soul. And you're the man who left his child in the caravan drunk. You condemned your child. She just carried out the sentence. Yeah.
Choices. You can stay and we can talk a little longer. Or you can go wait in a cell for a few hours and then we can talk a little longer.
What do you want to know?
You don't think your wife's condition was a convenient distraction from what was really going on?
I know my wife. She wasn't there. And I know if I called the police or a doctor, they would have pumped her full of lithium. And locked her in a padded cell with that thing inside her. Please come in.
Father Patrick.
Spoke out on the phone. Thanks for coming.
So where's your wife now?
She's upstairs. Thanks. She's coming.
Have you called a psychiatrist?
We thought about it.
Father, are you able to perform exorcisms?
Exorcisms went out in about the 1600s. No matter what you've seen in the movies, they are pretty much extinct. And psychology has taken over now, and mental illnesses usually account for the most cases of peculiar activity. We stopped witch hunts, too.
What about miracles? Does the church have a scientific explanation for that?
Miracles are real. Say this entity or demon, if that's what it is, speaks to you?
He said he was the Lightbringer, also known as Morning Star.
He also said he was King of the Flies, whatever that means.
Well, Lucifer is a more common name for Lightbringer, which translates into Morning Star. Belial is the Lord of the Flies. I mean, all these are references to the devil. I mean, it being the devil itself, however, I mean, stretches the outer reaches of likelihood and even possibility.
Look, Father, my wife is in the other room. Something pretty unfriendly inside her. So I'm a bit ready to try anything you've got.
All right. So what do you think may have attracted the devil to your wife?
He means, is she a bad person?
She's as good as gold.
If that's the case, it is possible that she was the victim of a poor environment. Morally speaking.
My daughter was raised in a wonderful environment, and morally speaking, what you're doing is actually fanning the flames of superstition. What are you recruiting by fear these days? Bethany doesn't need a priest. She doesn't need a psychic. She needs medical help. It is in the middle of the night. I'm going home. But I will be back in the morning with a professional in tow.
Jean.
Mom, I'll walk you out.
Jean. Thank you.
The devil my ass. I will be back tomorrow. You hold the fort, hmm?
Someone we can see her, preferably. Normally no, but under these circumstances, I think it's best we wait before we attempt anything else. Dark powers are strongest in the late hours.
Why don't you stay over, Father? We'd all feel safer with you around.
No, I must go and pray and seek guidance from the church of how best to fight this. Please try and keep Bethany as comfortable as possible. Stay together. You're stronger that way. And I'll see you in the morning, Maggie.
So, Bethany?
Bethany's tied up downstairs in the living room.
No.
Yeah, she is. Are you okay?
Yeah.
So what was your wife's relationship with Michael? I understand they used to date.
I think you're swimming up the wrong stream there, Dr. Woods.
And what stream would that be, Luke?
The one that says my wife's a whore.
Oh, I didn't say that.
We're done here.
Okay, let's back it up. What was the reason that you were spying on him in his room?
I wasn't spying on him.
I thought I saw her go up the stairs.
So you were jealous?
No. Yes. Look, I was downstairs. I went to the bathroom. I could have sworn I saw her go up the stairs.
Bishop has given me permission to monitor the situation in a more official capacity. Where is everybody?
Inside, come in.
So, Father, what now?
Well, for the church to allow me to perform an exorcism, I need to show a case of possession.
What are we looking for?
Several things. I mean, the church's list is rather lengthy for this sort of approval. I mean, to begin with, speaking in a foreign tongue.
Sona, si latina lo cuerpo.
What did she say?
Sona, si latina lo cuerpo.
It's Latin, right? Are you kidding? Bethany don't speak Latin.
Right, I don't know. Latina lo cuerpo.
It appears she does now.
In third, I'm not doing it.
Well, you've proved your point, Spirit.
I'm not a parent.
Yes. Let's do this.
Your brother died poorly, Father. You're in attendance at his hour of death.
Nicholas. How did you know that?
I know these things. Get used to it. Do you remember what he whispered to you?
I do.
The Catholics still believe suicide to be an unforgivable sin.
Yes.
So, tell me, Father, why, when he asked you with his dying breath if you would go to hell, did you tell him yes?
I'm bound by the truth. And Jesus said that suicide
is... You're not being like him. Jesus was a carpenter.
He was.
God, you just nailed and screwed him up, eh, Padre?
The Lord will protect me and the others and the girl that you've so wrongfully injured.
I'll scar the girl's inside eye and a sanity nail never find it.
You have no control here.
There's something!
Help, help, help! Oh,
God. Untie her!
Please help. Please help.
Is he going to stop that? Seems to be gathering strength. It's trying to create fear. Fear is our worst enemy. Now we must pray and wait for this demon to show its hand. For us to take our time.
Can you just please do something? You can't take this anymore.
Like, how we know what it wants?
Maybe it's a test, like Job or something.
Job? What the hell is Job?
Satan challenged God by saying that Job only praised him because of all the gifts that God has given him. So, God told Satan that he could test Job's faith in any way he wished. Providing he didn't kill him. So, the devil responds by taking away Job's family. Destroying his crops, slaying his cattle, turning his friends against him. But instead of turning away from the Lord, as the devil hoped, he asked for forgiveness of his sins. He not only prayed for his own sins, but for the sins of his sons, never once doubting his faith, and thus proving the devil wrong.
How could God give permission to the devil to annihilate someone's life? That's fucked up.
Yeah, this place has got some seriously bad energy, but something told me I should come back. Plus, I missed you guys. Hannah. Oh, I see you brought in the God Squad. Greetings, Padre.
It's Father Patrick.
Samara.
The psychic.
Oh, yes. Interesting.
Thank you. I would have chosen mysterious and beautiful, but interesting's good. So how's our little demon doing today?
My puppet on a string. Are you flirting with me? Those voices you hear, your so-called guardian angels, you know them very well. You can't tell the difference between them and me. Why don't you go back to sticking your fingers down your throat? You can't save her. She's not worth dying for.
Yeah, well, I'll be the judge of that.
Because you can't be everywhere all at once, my sassy little spirit. And right now, may I remind you, you are cowering behind a lady dude.
Suck my dick, bad.
Whip it out, bitch.
So now.
Waste of time. We should all be preparing.
Then I'll
for forgiveness. Each of us, priest included. You also have a husband. I need your love and prayers.
Will it be enough?
Don't underestimate yourself, Hannah. More candles, matches, and most likely more duct tape.
Well, I can get candles and matches. The duct tape is down in the basement.
Where in the basement? I'll get it.
It's on the shelves. There's a whole bunch of it.
No, you shouldn't go alone. I should probably accompany you.
Oh, that's sweet, Father. I'm a big girl. I think I can manage.
After you're done here, can you go check on her?
Gonna do this.
No, we're ready. As soon as Samara gets back with the doctor.
That's outside.
Come on.
kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
I'm so sorry. If you would only come out and just stop this, I promise I will never lie to you again.
Never lie. I'll do a deal with you, Luke. You just tell Bethany, tell her about Christy. Tell her about your little accident. I'll let her go.
Don't listen, Luke. It's just trying to exhaust you.
Shut up! Fire boy.
I won't let her go no matter what you say.
Tell her the truth, Luke. I'll let her go.
And why is that interesting, demon?
Because it'll condemn his spirit to hell.
What'll it be, cowboy? Tell Bethany. I'll let her go.
Okay. I'll tell her. You know how, well, you remember one night last year, I got home so late,
yeah.
And I told you I hit something on the road?
Yeah, he hit a deer, he hit a deer. Yeah. What did he do?
Baby, I gave up drinking, remember? And you know, the reason was because that night I was drunk and it was raining so heavily. Baby, I didn't hurt a deer.
What did you do? What did you do?
I can't do this. Please, God.
Luke didn't hit a deer. Luke hit a woman with his car. He was too much of a coward to help her because her jaw was 3 feet from her face. Coward. Luke. Is it true?
It was, I didn't... It's not the way. It was an accident. I didn't fucking mean it!
I'll take Luke upstairs. I'll make a deal with you, Maggie. Tell us what you want. I'll let her go.
Shut the fuck up. I bargained with no demon. I've done nothing wrong.
You can't have him. He's not gonna leave God for you. I know what makes you tick. Tick. Tock. Tick. Tock. Maggie wants the Padre's car.
I'll kill you!
Make sure she doesn't escape.
I'm sorry, Father. I was never going to do anything, I swear.
Sometimes God and the devil, they test our strengths. And they come in many forms.
I don't want to be tested. I just want you. Please, please, leave this. Leave with me. They don't care. They don't deserve to be saved. Can't you see that?
No. Jesus died for the forgiveness of sins. I can't turn my back on him. My faith won't allow it.
God, what am I... Fuck! What am I saying? I can't believe I want to abandon my friends.
No, no. Maggie, you've done nothing wrong.
I'm so afraid. Please help me. Please.
I can't give in to temptation. I refuse to let the devil win.
Maggie, you should be thanking me. Good, you're all here. Thank you for making see the death in your faces.
I'm calling the police now.
With what? 2 yoga cups and a piece of string?
It's not working. Why isn't it working?
None of your phones work, you stupid bitch. Who are you going to call, your mom? She won't answer.
What do you want?
I just want to play.
If you want to kill us, please, just kill us now.
No fun.
I'm done playing. Watch this. Kill her myself if you want me to.
Do it for me, Daddy.
Michael, you don't want this.
Yes, I do.
Michael.
Move.
Please.
Move.
Please.
Move. Move.
What's wrong with you? You got a kitten in your purse?
Drop these wounds.
Michael, no!
Sinners, and not one of you would turn to God for help.
Not one of you had faith. So here's your choice. Kill yourself. And save your sister. Sacrifice yourself for her. Or she dies. And you live.
You lie. You lie!
Oh, ye of little faith. How I adore thee.
Do you really think Bethany would have stabbed herself in the chest? Or do you think it's more likely Hannah would stab her sister because she suspected her of sleeping with her husband? What do you think? Hannah came totally unhinged over Emma's death and felt threatened. Once her family knew her secret, she would always be the woman whose neglect caused the death of her baby. Where was Hannah when her mother died?
She left, didn't she?
She couldn't let her mother leave the house. She knew her secret, and Hannah knew she'd never keep it to herself. Who made the drinks that night? She could have given Bethany any number of drugs. Drugs that made her as delusional as Hannah needed her to be. Where was Hannah when Samara was killed?
In Emma's room.
Did you see her there? And how do you know?
I was there. I saw Bethany throw people across the room. She knew things that no one could have told her.
So what makes more sense? A hallucination? Or the devil in the living room? Okay. This allows me to transcribe what we've talked about. Thank you for being so cooperative. After you sign that, you're free to go.
Where are the others?
Well, they're next door. I'm not finished.
You're wrong about tonight, Doctor. The devil was there. You'll see. I can't wait to see the look on your face when you do.
Go get some rest. Hey, get
everything needed from her?
Oh, yeah. I didn't need her. She'd been released.
Listen, I think you need to talk to Luke one more time. He just mentioned something in the interrogation room about a hit and run last September. I don't know. I could barely understand him. I think we need you.
Just to clean up with a few more questions, and don't let them go until I tell you, okay?
All right, no problem.
Come get me if they give you a hard time. Oh, I'll take care of Hannah. All right?
Yep.
On your face, you think you figured it out, don't you? If anyone can do what I can, they call it a miracle. People don't question what Jesus did. Even if you can't understand, it doesn't mean it didn't happen. Close your mouth, Neil. It's not flattering. Much better. Come on, it's so easy. Think. Do I have to spell it out for you? It's a test, Neil.
Like Job, remember? The priest was a surprise. I didn't expect him to fall for man's oldest desire. But I was wrong. The psychic was a false prophet. She was always destined to be with me. The real game was the test for the others. Michael, a loving husband, but a better adulterer. His immorality led to his own self-destruction. Luke, the murderer. Yes, he did confess in the end, but just not to God. Hannah cannot take. She was the only one to turn to him. And one day her soul will be reunited with that of her daughter. God can have them both, Bethany too. But as for her unborn child, well, I can't tell you everything. I chose this family after watching them for a while. I mean, between murderers and adulterers, my odds were pretty high. It's more about watching people fail than just taking their souls. And you, Neil, pretending to be the protector of truth, but you forget only God can judge. You had all the evidence in front of you, and yet you've just condemned an innocent woman. Do you see? You betrayed God. It's time to go, Neil. Your soul's mine. All of you meet me at least once. I take many forms. You can call me Temptation, but I am Lucifer, the Lightbringer. I am Belial. I am the Morning Star.